we should be seeing the first round match here on table two, which is between Zhenyi Wang of Poland and Hugo Hoyama of Brazil. And it promises to be an excellent meeting. Both experienced, Wang the higher ranked of the two, but Hoyama of Brazil making an appearance in his sixth Olympic Games. He's the player in the green top at the far side, standing with the two officials. There is the camera with the red top and the spectacles is Zhenyi Wang, who was born in Tianjin in China, but then moved to Poland and took citizenship. Venue announcer going through all the matches on the four courts, introducing all the players and the officials, so it will take a moment or two. The players being introduced to the audience. Hugo Hoyama, 43 years of age, not ranked in the world's top 200. And the umpire is Hamid Sabagia from Iran. His assistant and timekeeper. Well, of all the first round matches in this men's competition, this could be one of the best. Zhenyi Wang, representing Poland, is currently ranked the 87th best player in the world. He's the one in the red top. But his opponent, Hugo Hoyama, really has seen it all before. He played in the Olympic Games in Barcelona in 1992. And this will be his sixth appearance in an Olympic tournament, spanning 20 years. Two players having a final word with their coaches before coming to the table to warm up. It's the best of seven games in the singles competition.
You need to have a big fan to change a lot about the game.
Playing to a total of 11, with a lead of 2 points required to win the game.
But if not, well, don't think I can risk incredible, you can wait a good one. Eh? And then after you need to have fun to try to change the rhythm of the game as you used to do. Huh?
Okay. Allez, guys, which is Jean-René Muni. Encouraging slap. And Hoyama made his debut for Brazil back in 1987, the Pan American Games. Both players use the penholder grip. Wang is right-handed and Hoyama is left-handed. players going through that rhythmic warm-up. Just a bit of a loosener, getting used to the atmosphere in the venue. Confirmation of our umpire, Hamid Reza Sabagian. Hoyama was born in São Bernardo do Campo in Brazil. Wang was born in China, moved to Poland with several other Chinese players. 18 years of age he was when he moved to Poland. Initially it was homesick, but then met a lady and married and settled down. And now representing Poland here in the Olympic Games. It'll be Hoyama of Brazil to serve first at the start of this men's singles match in the first round of the Olympic competition against Zengyi Wang of Poland. Each player serving twice. Now Wang, the right-hander, pen holder grip, 87th best player in the world. Hoyama not ranked in the world's top 200. And 14 years the elder. On the run, on the stretch. Couldn't quite get it back on the tabletop, forced very wide. Using a high thrown serve. And three apiece in the first game, still a long way to go, but there won't be very much between these two. May go the distance. Wang was a winner on the ITTF Professional Tour in 2008, won the Polish Open. Hoyama has been a Latin American team champion and men's doubles champion. He's very, very quick. Quick eye, quick reflexes. Likes to get in and attack the ball early. Great backhand on the diagonal, changing the angle, just completely isolating his opponent. We might be in for some really thrilling rallies. By the way, Hoyama wears underwear in the same colour as his football team. Superstition. Green and white. Thank you. The winner of this match, incidentally, will go obviously through to the second round, where they will meet Easy Wen of Spain, who's ranked in the world at number 68. Higher ranked players coming into the competition at the second round stage, and the top 16 ranked players in the competition coming in at the third round stage. It's staggered. And that's the first game, 11-8 to Brazil. Just the 3 points in it, but a more experienced Hugo Hoyama closing out that opening game. 11-8. Thomas Radzymski is the Polish coach.
And maybe we do only this, then don't go like a crazy, maybe it's a little bit high, you have to be careful about this. And then you make some variation because you serve so well. And now you are playing perfectly. Yeah? Allez, have the same fight. Huh? Good, Hugo.
Quite nice to eavesdrop on the advice and instructions that the two coaches are giving. Difficult to do it with the Polish coach and his player because they were talking in Polish, but Jean-René Muni, national coach for Brazil. Little fortunate clip off the top of the net. Wang had to stretch and was then way out of position. Raised hand to acknowledge the good fortune. Bounced back on the Brazilian side. A silver medalist in the European Championships in 2009 in Stuttgart, finishing in second place in the men's doubles. Hoyama has been a Pan American Games team champion. It was played last year, 2011, in Guadalajara, Mexico. He will attack anything which is a little bit high. Great serve. Hoyama was halfway out of the court trying to retrieve it. The umpire shouted let there. Wang's return was right on the white line on the edge of the table. The second one was long. 5-all. He's now, by the way, the joint record holder for the most appearances by a Brazilian athlete in the Olympic Games. Game point. Wang can go on and secure this game. It will be all square. One game apiece. Game point saved by Hoyama. Needs one more, and it will be alternate serves. Oh, it was a great backhand on a great angle. Hoyama trying to chase it down, but there was no hope of retrieving that, and thumbs up indeed for Xingyi Wang, who's leveled the scores in this men's singles match. Now it's one game apiece. Hoyama was left swinging at thin air. So Hoyama took the first 11-8. Wang has responded, winning the second 11-9.
First lateral in forehand, then you serve without spin or like down spin or no spin, but not lateral side. Huh? Second thing, I mean, when you serve with his backhand, try to make him step in the line. Like, don't put in his backhand, because if you can, really fast. But if not, this is much better to keep like.
Radzymski, the Polish coach, getting his message across as well. With the score, and there's a nice close-up of the bat showing the rubber each side of the bat covered with a layer of rubber with pimples sometimes facing inwards, sometimes facing outwards. Each imparts a different spin on the ball. They're strictly controlled now by the ITTF. Not only the rubbers that are used, but also the adhesives, the glues that are used, strictly controlled. Well, the first point in game three goes to Wang of Poland. Score level at one game all, this men's first round singles match. Changes to the table tennis rules for this Olympic tournament. in the team competition, it's switched from a group format to a straight knockout competition. Team events for men and women will begin when the men's and women's singles events have concluded. The maximum number of players that each nation is able to enter in the singles events has been reduced from 3 to 2. So no nation can now repeat what China did in 2008 and in one of the categories make a clean sweep of gold, silver and bronze. Rules that open up the way for other nations to win table tennis medals. Sport very much dominated by China, though. They've won 20 of the 24 gold medals awarded in table tennis since it became an Olympic event. And it's not only the Chinese players in the Chinese national team who do well, it's the Chinese players who've moved overseas and now represent other countries. Wang at full stretch, unable to return. So advantage Brazil at this midpoint stage in game three. A loose serve. The applause was not for the mistake, it's for something happening on an adjoining table. Hoyama says that his nickname, by the way, is Mr. Magoo. He trails. Now he has two serves. Hoyama to serve. Needs both these points to close out this third game and lead by 2 games to 1. And that's game point. That contorted backhand return from the midriff goes along. It's another game point that's gone. Still game point though to Hoyama of Brazil. And that serve. Oh, and a real mix-up on the server. Zengi Wang was trying to disguise that. He was almost trying to get his body in front of it. You have to show your opponent the ball, and they're supposed to be able to see the moment of impact. It was as if Wang was trying to disguise his intention on that serve, and he got it wrong. And as a result, Hoyama has won the third game 11-9 and now leads by 2 games to 1. Well, either player needs to win 4 games to win the match, this first round match in the men's competition. best of seven. Still could be a long way to go, but Hoyama with the advantage of leading by 2-1.
This is perfect, same, huh?
Says he took up the sport when he was aged 7 back in Brazil. Had an injury a couple of years ago which kept him out for several months. Wang moved to Poland and found a wife, Anna, and they now have a daughter, Sarah. Good. Taking it early. Backhand was good, but the forehand, see the spin on that as well. Like a leg break in cricket. And again, Hoyama demonstrating that extraordinary ability to get the ball back from almost right in front of his tummy, in front of his midriff, but in the end it was a point to Wang. Certainly brings a lot of experience to the table. Competed in Barcelona, Atlanta, Sydney, Athens, Beijing, and now London. Been extraordinary if he'd managed to play that one back from behind his own back. Off the edge of the bat into the adjoining court. Stop. Pushed it wide, pushed it too wide. Hoyama knows this could be a critical game. If he could close this one out, the 43-year-old Brazilian facing the serve here of Wang, he would lead 3-1 in games and would need just the one more. Edging closer. This is the point for the change of serve. And it's Hoyama needing 2 points. Game point. Two serves that Wang couldn't return give Hoyama the fourth game by 11 points to 9, and he now leads by 3-1. Took the first 11-8, Wang responded winning the second 11-9, but Hoyama triumphing 11-9, 11-9 in the next two games. Best of 7, he needs one more. Well, is it crisis time for Zingyi Wang, 29 years of age, bespectacled figure, ranked at 87 in the world? Is he about to lose against an opponent who isn't ranked in the world's top 200? Hugo Hoyama returns to the table with the encouragement of his coach ringing in his ears. He leads by 3-1. This is the start of game 5 in this men's singles match. Zingyi Wang of Poland to receive. Takes the first point. This is the game that Wang cannot afford to lose. He was at full stretch then to try and retrieve that. And Hoyama keeping the serve tight, forcing Wang to stretch and make mistakes. That just nicked the edge of the table. And we might see quite a lot of toweling down in this fifth game. I'm gonna play on it. Takes both points on his serve. to bring it back to all square, four apiece. Turn of the serve by Wang was terrific. It was right on the edge and it really forced Hoyama out of position. Wang was then in control. This is a very useful lead in a game that he can't afford to lose. Let me take this last point on his serve now. Too high, too much height, too much of an invitation for your opponent to knock it away. There, look, set up really nicely. Looks at the moment as if Wang has taken control of this fifth game. He needs a couple more points here. Keep the match alive. It's gone long. It's a great run of points to Wang, who now has five game points to pull a game back. And there it is. Wang takes game five quite comfortably, 11-5. And suddenly it's not quite so easy. Hoyama leading by 3-2. Can he take one of the two games that remain to go through to round two? Will Wang stage an impressive comeback? He was once part of a Polish table tennis squad that staged a strike. They were suspended in 2011 after leaving a national camp because they felt the conditions weren't quite good enough. Complained about a lack of good food and such like. Hoyama is the one looking for answers as we await the start of game six. Well, you always thought this was a men's first round match which could be entertaining and which might go the distance. And it could yet. Wang serving at the start of game six, trailing by 2-3. Still needs to win this game to keep it alive and take us into a seventh and final deciding game. Two points to Hoyama. Set up an inch or two too high. And a dropping of the point on his first serve. Wang steering the ball down both flanks on the diagonal, dragging Hoyama around. Taking that one very early, playing it into a completely open court. And it dropped over on the Polish player's side. Going to get it back. And then knocking it long. Is he just beginning to feel the effort and exertion here? Occasionally he's blowing heavily. Tremendous flexibility of the wrist in that penholder grip to get the bat onto the ball and direct it where you want it to go. Four all. The unfathomable serve. Four, he leads. Hoyama serving. Needs these points. He's taken the first of them. Unreturnable. And they don't that wing open. And it's a timeout. Wang getting a bit of an air bashing here. Just the 1 point separates them. Wang said that he was in tears when he qualified for the London 2012 Olympic Games, never having been in an Olympic tournament before. Said it wasn't an especially difficult tournament from which he qualified. It was out in Doha. Nevertheless, when he won the last point, it was a great relief. So he grabbed the phone and sent text messages to his wife and his parents and had a good weep. It's advantage Brazil. They lead 3-2. Hoyama needs 3 points. Oh, that was a wonderful, wonderful rally and a great play by Wang. Good recovery as well by Hoyama. He's sprinting all over the place, one side to the other. Then thought he'd put that one away, but somehow Wang got back to ball. And Hoyama wasn't at home. And another timeout. Now he has doubt. We heard that, didn't we? Does he have doubt? Hoyama within 3 points of winning this first round match. And trailing by just one. And it's difficult to separate them.
But after, if you do more in the middle, don't get too fast in your forward pass. You go.
Come on. Now you're on
you. It could all be over in it. Just a few short, sharp rallies here. Alternatively, we could be going into a seventh game. Hoyama to serve. Wang took him very wide. It was right on the edge of the table. Now we're 8-all. Now it's advantage Poland. Just waiting, there's a tannoy announcement. Just waiting for things to settle down, isn't it? Quick hitting. And Wang takes the point. It's game point to make the scores level at 3-all. And Wang are throwing the towel down quite aggressively, irritated with himself. This serves to come. He's got to win both points. And looks a little bit disheartened and disappointed, certainly, as that one goes long, because it means that Zengi Huang of Poland has leveled it at 3-all, winning that sixth game, 11-8, having trailed at one stage in that game, and we will now go to a seventh and final deciding game. Oh, it's been a very entertaining match. An indication perhaps of what's to come in this men's singles tournament and the table tennis events here in the XL Arena in London during these 2012 Olympic Games. The big guns haven't yet entered the competition. The top 16 ranked players in the world, the 16 players who are ranked highest in the world, who are in the competition, will come in at the third round. The 16 next ranked highest players come in round two. So Wang and Hoyama are playing for the privilege of getting through to the second round, where one of them will meet He Ziwen of Spain, who was ranked 68 in the world. And it will be difficult from then on, because the player that the winner of that would meet in the third round is ranked 15 in the world. So it's Hoyama, Hugo Hoyama of Brazil, serving first at the start of this seventh and final game against Zengi Wang of Poland. Level at 3-all. First to 11 points will go through to the second round. Wang trailed 3-1 in games, came back to win the next two. And suddenly there's mistakes being made by the 43-year-old Brazilian. 3 points to Wang. and a serve to come. Again, dropped over on the Brazilian side. Too much height on the return from Wang. It got what it deserved. Players now take a grip on this seventh game. Two-point advantage for the 29-year-old Chinese-born Polish player in the red shirt, ranked at 87 in the world. Both players with the pen holder grip, Wang right-handed. Hoyama left, also. Trying to just nudge it back over the net and catch Hoyama out. Advantage swings from one player to the other. Five all, six all. Remember, you need to win by two clear points. First man to 11. If you're not leading by two clear points, it's alternate serves. And the game carries on. Six all. That was a let. And then to serve again. That the decisive moment. Wang will serve here, but he's trailing now 6-8. He's pulled one of them back with some really aggressive play. 7-8, still him to serve. Hit the top of the net, I think that. Has knocked it long, it's 8-all. Well, three games apiece, 8 points apiece. Could it get any closer? Well, it could be 10-all, couldn't it? Just for a moment, it seemed that that return from Wang might have clipped the edge of the table, but now the point goes to Brazil, 9-8. And that's long. It's match point. No wonder they're both taking time out to go and have a good towel down. 1 point required for Hoyama of Brazil to go through to the second round. And he saved one. And he's still got a serve to come. Wang can make it 10-all. And he has. 3 games apiece, 10 points apiece, alternate serves now. And a player needs to establish a 2-point lead to win the game and to win the match and to go through to the second round. Oh, Hoyama served first, but he was hopelessly out of position to return. Wang seizing the moment. Now it's match point to Poland, to Zengi Wang. And he serves. Oh, and Hoyama can't return. It goes into the bottom of the net. What a comeback. He trailed 1-3 in games. And the 29-year-old world's 87th best player, according to the ITTF rankings, has come from 1-3 down to win the next 3 games and go through by 4-3. An absolutely absorbing men's singles first round match. There's the confirmation of the scoring, but it's the three last games, 5, 6 and 7, which count. 11-5, 11-8, 12-10.